Hey, welcome to YouTube. This is Sports Radio Speech. I want to talk to you guys about Gotham Season 4, Episode 2, A Fear, a Fear Reaper. And in the episode, we see Gordon, you know, trying to take down Jonathan Crane, aka Scarecrow, to still prove the fact that GCPD is still some of the motherfuckers to mess with. Alright? And, you know, we saw pretty much Jonathan Crane tell Gordon several times, like, listen, man, I'm no longer that scared little boy, you know, and Gordon's trying to tell him, like, man, your father tried to kill you, I just saved your life, you know, and Scarecrow's pretty much like, man, no, my father was trying to help this world, was trying to eradicate fear forever, make everyone fearless, you know, but clearly we saw that Jonathan Crane was just this terrified, mortified little kid, and still was up until his young adolescent age, and things of that nature. So Jonathan Crane decides to wreak havoc inside of Arkham Asylum by, you guessed it, spraying his fear juice all over the tenants of the asylum. 100 tenants to be exact. And, you know, so after, you know, with Gordon only going there by himself because, you know, pretty much GCPD is like, man, forget about it. Penguin's right, man. I mean, none of us have gotten shot, none of us have gotten hurt, none of us have gotten killed since this whole legalized crime thing has happened. So even Harvey and even his partner Harvey said hell no to this. He said, one day I told you it was going to be now or never, and today is going to be the day I choose never. So, you know, of course, Gordon went there by himself to apprehend Crane, you know, with some obstacles in his way, you know. Crane actually being able to actually use some of his fear juice on Gordon himself. We actually find out what he's afraid of, which I believe it happens to be his wife. You know, she feels like they could have had a life together, but he was so caught up probably in his work that they just couldn't let it happen. You know, she was in a bathtub full of blood with her own blood because she slit her wrists, you know, things of that nature. And then we also see Tabitha and Selina, you know, still over the shock, the fact that Barbara is alive. I guess Barbara was a small time once at one point an ally of Tabitha and Selina, who did them wrong. As we all heard, you know, Tabitha telling us that Barbara had Cobblepot chop off Butch and her Enigma making Tabitha cut off her hand, and you know she's gonna do the same to Barbara. But then, you know, she said, you know what, Freedom, I'll trust you for now. You know, because Barbara came back strong. You know, she had all these weapons, to which Cobblepot actually saw for himself and said, you know what, I'm going to give you a little weapons tax. Every single time, you know, you decide to, you know, to give some of my men some weapons, and if you refuse, I'll have Victor here use this, your own merchandise. I'll have him use your own merchandise to kill you, and things of that nature, so. And then when Jim comes back from apprehending Jonathan Crane, you know, Cobblepot obviously isn't happy about it. You know, things like that. And, you know, Bruce finally met Mr. Fox. You know, Mr. Fox finally hooked him up with his starter Batman gear. So I look forward to it, man. You know, we also see what looks to be the birth of Poison Ivy. So I look forward to seeing that as well. Mr. Bush Speaks.